बिस्मिल्लाह रहमान रहीम, अस्सलाम वालेकुम। लेट्स स्टार्ट आवर नेक्स्ट टॉपिक, बजटिंग इन पाकिस्तान अंडर द कोर्स ऑफ इकोनॉमिक्स एंड फाइनेंसिंग ऑफ एजुकेशन, EDUC 4124। इन दिस यूनिट वी विल सी द फॉलोइंग टॉपिक्स। नंबर वन, द कॉन्सेप्ट, रोल एंड पर्पज ऑफ बजटिंग। वी मस्ट हैव नोन द टर्म बजटिंग एंड एवरी वन हु इज कंसर्न्ड विद बाइंग एंड सेलिंग ही डज बजटिंग, वेदर दैट इज रिटन एंड प्री प्लान्ड और वेदर दैट इज ऑन द स्पॉट एंड रेकरेंट। फेजेज ऑफ बजटिंग, टाइप्स ऑफ बजटिंग, डिवेलपमेंटल वर्सेज नॉन डिवेलपमेंट बजट एंड एट द एंड सम ग्लॉसरी ऑफ बजट टर्म्स। इंट्रोडक्शन। बजटिंग इज द फाइनेंशियल पार्ट ऑफ प्लानिंग। इट मीन्स दैट इट इज अ होल एंड ब्रॉडर टर्म। अंडर दिस फाइनेंशियल पार्ट इज डेल्ट, वी प्लान फॉर आर फ्यूचर इन मॉनिटरी टर्म्स, इन फाइनेंशियल टर्म्स। बजट इज एन इम्पॉर्टेंट टूल इन द हैंड्स ऑफ अ ट्रेन्ड हेल्थ प्रोफेशनल। So, for all the people who belong to the costing and purchasing of something, they do budgeting. We will compare the two terms, budgeting and financing, here. Starting from budgeting, it is a concrete, precise picture of the total operation of an enterprise in monetary terms. So, in totality, whatever all the activities will be done under a business enterprise, all the operations in monetary terms will be seen broadly. Whereas financing, it is concerned with the maintenance and creation of economic value or wealth. So we can say that budgeting is a broader term and financing is one part of the budgeting. It is an operational plan. Budgeting is an operational plan for definite period, usually a year, whereas the financing is management of money and other valuables which can be easily converted into cash. So this is financing is the practical and implementation part, whereas budgeting is the planning part. Budgeting is broader term and financing is short term. Next question is, who pays for education? It means that whatever we plan for our educational system, how likely we distribute the resources among different alternatives under education, this is who pays for education. Who people are responsible for making education accessible? So this is read and answer is given through the precision of a given adequate financial statistics. Stat हमें बताती है, financial stats हमें बताती है कि तालीम पे कौन पैसा खर्च करता है. Generally speaking, we say that on the policy making level, then the provincial level, and then the institutions, and then under the institutions, authorities and the subordinates. We see that there is a hierarchy of finances distribution in the educational system. Next is definition of budget. Budget is an anticipated receipt and available resources of an organization during the given years. It is a process of preparing the budget. So we cannot say that budgeting is only comprised on one year. It says that it is a planning component, that how likely resources will be organized and distributed during a given period of time. Concept of budget. A budget is a plan of financial operation embodying an estimate of the purposed expenditure, proposed expenditures for a given period, and purpose and proposed mean of financing them. So in this definition we see that financing is under budgeting. We see how to finance under a given period of time and what will be the financial operation or the action, practical action will be taken. This is decided under budget planning. Role of budgeting. The budget is a planning economy, is a budget of national resources and output capacity. So, budget plays the role of planning the economy as well as the national resources and their outputs. Number 2 point says, budget can be drawn up in the term of annual plans, because basically and generally the budgeting is done for a fiscal year, which is a one year, the period of 1 year. So we see the annual plans. We can draw the annual plans in the light of the budgeting. Purpose of budgeting. Number one, to formulate the objectives of development. Because without budgeting, we cannot run any program. So objectives of planning of development are formulated under the light of budgeting to provide means of coordinating activities of different departments. Without the coordination among different departments, work cannot be done. So budget provides you the opportunity that how likely you can coordinate the activities within the departments. To streamline the management of public funds, because there are so many resources, we must know that what are the maximum or range of resources. So public funds is one of the resources that needs to be planned under budgeting. Phases of budgeting. In the coming slides we will see that what are the phases of budgeting. Budget kaise kaise banta hai. Number one, phase one, identification of the programs. Sabse pehle to hum sari alternatives ko jahan jahan paisa kharch karna hai unki identification karenge aur unko list out karenge. It means projects to be accomplished during the budget period. All the projects, those needs to be accomplished during the budget period. Phase 2, identification of the resources in term of manpower, money, machinery and material. Without knowing the range of all the resources, we cannot plan the budget. So on the phase 2, we plan our resources and identify all the range of resources, whether that is in the part of, in the form of manpower. In the previous chapter number 3, we have gone through the concept of manpower planning approach. So what is manpower? The educated people who are going to provide certain services. Then the money, which is the direct needs to be planned, machinery, the equipment and the material, the resources. So we identify the resources in phase 2. Phase 3, costing of resources. We determine the value of those resources. The budget is fundamentally a financial statement. Hence, costing becomes the most effective activity in the budgeting. So we determine the cost of all the resources in phase 3. Phase 4, presentation of budget. In this we present the budget to a body who is authorized to implement that and or make them asked to make revisions. The budget is formulated according to budgetary guidelines from time by the proper authorities. In the phase 5, obtaining approval of the appropriate authority. The final stage of budgeting involves piloting the budget through a series of budget hearing. So piloting means that you do not implement all the budget to the whole population, rather you implement the budget on a portion of the whole population so that you can determine the outcomes of that budgeting. Next, we will see some types of budget. There are three basic types of budgeting. Number one, line item budget. Number two, performance budget. Number three, planning programming budgeting system, which is also called PPPS. So, with their names, it is clearly evident what is the idea behind them. We will see them one by one. Number one is line item budget. Its name says that we can make a list of all the things to be purchased and then we can plan our money or budget them. It emphasizing listing of objects for itemized expenditure such as personal, supplies and equipment. A timeline budget is the most traditional type of budget. So in this budget we list all the objects to which we need to spend money. In the second type of budget, that is performance budget, a performance budget is a management oriented budget. Performance budget use statements of mission, goals and objectives to explain why the money is being spent. So it does not only focus on spending on money, but also see the effectiveness, the reason why we are going to spend on certain or particular things. It also sees that, and that is relevant and measured with the goals and objectives at hand. In the third type, which is planning program budgeting system, PPBS, as an approach helps educational planners and educational administrators to determine the accountability of the educational system and to make decisions. So it is also clear with its name that it provides you the grounds of proper planning the programs and their budgeting system, and also determine the accountability among different educational system. Here is a comparison between developmental budget and non-development budget. Developmental budget it refers to the budget of the government which helps in economics and real income of the country. The main heads on this budget are cost of spending, scholarship, development of land or cost of a civil work. Whereas non-development budget is prepared on the basis of the previous year budget. The main heads on this budget are petrol, oil and lighting, service charges, electricity, water bills, etc. There is a glossary. Glossary means all the difficult terms used in the context of economics of education, and those terms will be told to you and you will learn. Under this topic, I have written 4 or 5 items relevant to this chapter, budgeting in Pakistan, whereas a detailed handout has been developed on the glossary, which includes all the important terms being used in this course, educational economics. So that will be shared in the upcoming lectures. Glossary of budget terms. Here are some terms you should be familiar with as you work with the school budget. So 2 or 3 items have been reported here. Adapted budget. The financial plan adopted by the governing body that forms a basis for appropriate plan of action, that is called adapted budget. That is molded up to the current scenario. Assessed value. It is a value set on real and personal taxable property as a basic for allocating taxes. Next is fiscal year. You must have heard about the fiscal year in the news every year when they offer budget. 12 months period beginning from July 1 and ending to June 30th is called a fiscal year. This is the duration written, but in the normal term it is called the fiscal year, 1 year period of time for which budget is implemented. Revenues, the money received by the local government from either tax or non-tax sources, that is all included in the revenue. So at the end we will see that what have been learned in this lecture. We have gone through the concept, role, purpose of budgeting. Then we have seen the five phases of budgeting, then that how budget is made and developed. Then we have seen the types of budgeting. In those types, three basic types of budgeting have been taught. And then we have compared the developmental budget with the non-developmental budget. And at the end, we have seen some glossary budget terms. Out of those, only four terms have been described. Others will be told in the coming lecture with the new handout named Glossary Terms. This is the end of the lecture. I hope you have understood the concepts told in this lecture. Thank you.